In this lecture, we're going to talk about how to register for your exam and what to expect. To register for your exam, go to isc2.org/register-for-exam. Then scroll down a little bit on the page and click Register for Exam. That takes you to another page. Here, you fill out all your personal information. Your name, your address, your country, phone number, employer, date of birth, and a bunch of other things. And a little bit of a warning here. When you fill out the first and the last name, it has to match exactly what's on your ID. If it does not match your ID, you'll get turned away at the testing center. Most of the questions make sense, but there is one where they ask you about the educational training program. And here, IC2 only lists official training partners, meaning I'm not on there. So unless you also took training from an official partner, just click None. Once you submit the form, IC2 is going to redirect you to the Pearson VUE website, and here you can schedule your exam. You pick the exam that you want to take, then you choose the language. Remember, you have 6 different languages you can take the exams in: simplified Chinese, English, German, Japanese, Korean, and modern Spanish. Then you look for a testing center in your area. You can choose up to 3 options. Once you have chosen the test centers where you want to see the available dates, you click Next in the bottom right corner, and then you're going to get shown the calendar for that testing center when they have the next openings. You pick the date, the time, and then you click Book this appointment. You pay for the exam and you finish the sign-up. And here, it's important to understand that getting certified is not just passing the exam. To get certified, you need to both pass your exam and you need to be endorsed. For the CISP, you need someone to endorse you. They can either, preferably, be someone who knows of your work experience and who is already ISC2 certified. They have to have an active certification. Now, if you, like many people, don't know someone else who is certified, then you can get endorsed by ISC2. The process is the same, but instead of someone who's certified, it's your boss or a coworker that says, yes, you have this experience, and they sign off on that. There is a slight chance of being audited, and if that happens to you, the person who signed your endorsement form will get contacted by ISC2. Another requirement for certification is that you commit to and fully support the ISC2 Code of Ethics. Even before the exam, learn these, know them by heart, they can show up on the exam, and if they do, both, it's excellent that you know them, and they're easy points for the exam. And those are the Protect Society, the Common Good, the Necessary Public Trust and Confidence in the Infrastructure, Act Honorably, Honestly, Justly, Responsibly, and Legally, Provide Diligent and Competent Service to the Principals, and Advance and Protect the Profession. And then once you're certified, you need to every year pay your AMF, your annual maintenance fee, and you need to earn CPEs, continuing professional education credits. So every year, you're going to give ISC2 some money to keep your certification active, and you're going to keep learning and prove that to ISC2. The CPEs are pretty easy to get. You can watch podcasts, you can watch video courses, anything really where you grow your knowledge in the field. I would also highly recommend look at the exam outline before you take the exam. Know how long you have, how many questions, and also know that you can pick the exam in multiple languages. All of ISC2's exams are available in English, Chinese, Japanese, Korean, German, and Spanish. And on the exam, there will be beta questions or pre-test items. And what that means is there are questions on your exam that you are not graded on and you don't know which they are. They are basically questions that ISC2 is testing out so they can see if they may or may not want to include them in future exams. Since you don't know which questions they are, they're not the first whatever number, they're randomly dispersed throughout the entire test. Answer all of the questions to the best of your ability. And to pass your exam, you need to score at least 700 out of a possible 1,000 points. Now, that doesn't mean that if you answer less than 70% of the questions right, you fail, because the questions are weighted. ISC2 is pretty close about what that means, but we assume that that means a very easy question could be worth 2 points, where a very hard question could be 10 points, or something like that. And once you have scheduled your exam, you have 365 days to either take the exam or reschedule it. If you need to cancel or reschedule your exam, you can do it online, and that has to be at least 48 hours before the exam, or you can do it by phone, and that has to be at least 24 hours before the exam. There will be a rescheduling or cancellation fee. Rescheduling is $50, cancellation is $100. And if you, within that 1 year, don't cancel, and don't sit for the exam, you lose your exam fee. And then as the final thing, ISC2 is always trying to keep their exams up to date, so normally every 3 years, they update all of their exams. You can on ICSquared.org go in and see when was the exam you're sitting for last updated and when is the next update. And with that, we are done with this lecture. I hope this has helped you answer some of the questions on how to register and what to expect on the exam. Thank you for being here, and I will see you in the next lecture.